We have been looking into this shloka. Yam vetti purusham prakritinchi gunaissaha sarvatha vartamanopi sa nasabhuyo bijayate. That is, prakriti and purusha have been described. How prakriti is starting from there, karana, and then finally panchabhutas, all these things, up to this sharira. This has been explained as prakriti. Prakriti vikriti. Remember that? Everything has been explained. And purusha. Who is this purusha? He is having guna sangha. Gunas are also karya. Gunas are also karya. It is called karana. Because taking support of the karana, they express themselves. Sattva rajas tamo guna, where do they express? They express only in the karanas. Okay. Therefore, gunas are also kshetra or prakriti. Now finally, purusha is having guna sangha with this. Bhagavan has created everything and he can do adhyasa, he has given sharira and all that. Therefore, he bhoktrutve heturuchyate. For his bhoktrutva, this is guna sangha is the karana. Okay. Now, suppose we understand it. Then everything is karya, but I am purusha, I am entirely different. But without understanding it, I am identifying myself with this. If I realize and I come to know myself as just, it was told, you know, upadrashtarmantaja, bharta bhokta maheshwara, paramatme japikto dehesman purushapara. Here in this body itself, he is there. So if you understand this real nature of purusha, freeing him from adhyasa, then sarvatha vartamanopi, let him live in any way you like. Let him live any way. There is nothing like liking. He simply lives, that's all. According to his samskara, he lives. Nasa bhuyo bhi jayate. Once again, he does not have another birth. I think all of you have understood. So now, nasa bhuyo bhi jayate, he does not take another birth. About that, the discussion is going on. Nanu yadyapi janmotpatti anantaram punarjanmabhavaha uktaha. Tathapi prajnanotpatte kritanam karmanam uttarakala bhavinancha yani adhikrantaneka janmakritani teshancha phalam adatva nasho niyuktaha iti syu trini janmani. Okay. What does it mean? He will not have nasa bhuyo bhijayate. So he will not have another birth. So the question raises, how can you say he will not have another birth? It's not possible. Because you have told after he has got jnana, okay, punarjanma bhavaha. Now, janma comes only because of the karma that has been done already. Now, you told that after jnana, he does not become means. What should happen to all this karma that he has done? Karma has been done by him before getting jnana. Now, this karma are actually three. What are they? Sanchita. Here, say Karishyamana. And Agava. Karishmana and Prarabdha. What exactly is Sanchita, you see? Sanchita is this. We will have done karma in each janma. In fact, we will have done so much of karma, it is not possible to experience all that karma in that janma itself. Something will always remain. In fact, this Sanchita is so hopelessly huge. A lot of karma is stored there. Okay. He is Sarvajna. Therefore, what he does is, at the time of Marana, his Janma, he chooses some of the karmas. Maybe he has done it in that Janma, or he has done it in Sanchita. Sanchita is there. Now, from this, he chooses and gives Vagvritti, Manovritti, Pranavritti. According to that, you will get a Janma. Now, similarly here, there is Sanchita is there. In Sanchita, both Punya and Papa will be there. And in Karishyamana Karma also, in this life, up to Jnana, getting Jnana, he has done karma. After getting Jnana, he simply doesn't die. He is also doing karma. Okay. Maybe he won't do either Punya or Papa. Okay. Or he may do because he is in a grihastha or something anyway, because Rajas were also there. He may also do Punya and Papa. Are you following? Yes. No. All this karma is there and Prarabdha is also there. What is Prarabdha? Prarabdha is that karma which he has brought in this life to be experienced. Agami is stored. It is in bank account. I can't withdraw. No. Fixed deposit. Okay. Now, Karishyamana is, now I am doing it. I have to experience sometime later. And Prarabdha, I have taken current account. Now I am using it. Okay. In all the three, there is both Punya and Papa. Okay. Therefore, what should happen to that karma? What exactly is karma? See, karma is I do some activity. By this kinetic activity, I will produce some potential energy. I lift a stone and keep it there. It contains potential energy. Okay. What should happen to it? Every karma accumulates like this. It is the form of potential. Okay. Therefore, that has to give phala. Suppose you say that doesn't give phala and all that, it leads to great confusion. Because he can do whatever he wants, he doesn't get any phala. Means it is nonsensical. Okay. And Shastra is simply teaching this is bad, this is good, do this, don't do this. All becomes meaningless. Okay. Therefore, karma should have phala. There is no doubt about that. Okay. Therefore, the question raises, what happens to all this karma that has done? See?
Prarabdha karma is what he gets for this birth.
Yes, well, exclusively for this birth.
For in this life, he will have to finish the temple of
prarabdha. Exactly. Exactly. He will have to finish it.
So, Sanchit is accumulated.
Sanchit is accumulated. Now I have done now, in this life. See, even in Prarabdha, you should know, what happens is, oh, I do prayaschitta. Suppose I have committed a mistake. I do prayaschitta. And I do prayaschitta, it will go also. But is prayaschitta is an antidote. I ate something which I should not have eaten. Okay. So I take a medicine and stomach will be all right. Like prayaschitta is just like that. Therefore, I commit a mistake, then I regret because of karma, I did it. Now I have to undergo the prayaschitta. Suppose I do prayaschitta. Then it will be cancer.
Swami, prayaschit ka prarabh se kya sambandh hua phir? Prarabh to hum pichle janmon se leke aaye hain, wo fixed hai. Abhi maine is janam mein koi galat kaam kiya, prayaschit to uske liye hai na?
Haan, theek hai.
Prarabh ka prayaschit se koi sambandh nahi hai?
Prarabh ka hi, ji. Prarabh di, I have eaten something in previous life. Now it is giving me stomachache.
But how do I know previous life mein maine kya galti kiya, Swami ji?
No, no. Kya galti matlab? The very fact that I experience pain is sufficient.
Okay,
I must have done it. Okay. That of course you will have to find out. Not whatever it is, please forgive me. That is also there. Maybe I don't know. But anyway, pain is there. You must please remove. I have to pray Bhagavan. Bhagavan is Sarvajna, therefore depending upon the power of your prayer, he will also reduce it. Okay. Therefore, prayaschitta is there. Prayaschitta is only that. Prayaschitta consists of three parts. Okay? Dana, upavasa, japa. Maybe I have told this. Okay. Dana, upavasa, japa. Now, kama, krodha, lobha are there, you know? These are the main villains which will create trouble. So lobha to counteract is dana. Okay. Then for kama it is upavasa. What is nirahara sidehina. That is if you put nirahara, kama will decrease. Not so. Then to reduce krodha, yeah, there is japa. So in every prayaschitta, you have japa, upavasa and dana. It will reduce papa.
Yagya
different...
Is not, yagya is not in
prayaschitta. Yagya. No, no. All these things, this prayaschitta karma could be of any type, depending on different people, different mistakes. They will all be different. Okay? Therefore, if he does it, it is compensated, it is gone. Is it clear? Therefore, maybe some papa has also gone. Not exactly every papa will go. Only for that which I have done, prayaschitta, it will go. Now, but punya certainly is there. Therefore, what should happen to it? So he says, jnanotpatte kritanam, prajnanotpatte kritanam, before getting jnana, karmanam, uttarakali bhavinancha, after getting jnana. Yancha adhikarantane kajanmani, kritani, that is sanchita, in the previous lives done. Teshancha phalam, adatva, nasho nayukta iti sihu trini janmani. There are three types of karma, so there must be three janmas for it. Or, if you don't sell that, kṛta pranāśo hi na yuktaite. Suppose you have done it, it is by itself it is lost if you say, then there is something wrong. Trini janma. Yathā bhale pravṛttānām ārabdha janmānām karmanām. No prārabdha you are telling. You have done it. You have to experience. What is the nature of prarabdha? You have done it, so you have to experience it. So it's only in the case of prarabdha this rule is there, not in the case of sanchita, is it? In the case of prarabdha, what you have done, you have to experience. In the case of sanchita also, it's the same. The rule applies. Okay, and karishma and karma also the same rule applies. Therefore, नच कर्मणा विशेष अवगम्यते देर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन संचितागम्य एंड प्रारब्ध द रूल हियर अप्लाइज देर ऑल्सो तस्मात् त्रिप्रकारण्यपि कर्माणि त्रीणि जन्मानि आरभेरन् थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ कर्मा विल हैव टू यू विल हैव टू हैव थ्री जन्मास आर संहतानि वा सर्वाणि एकं जन्म आरभेरन् दैट इज ऑल द थ्री टुगेदर एटलीस्ट इट मस्ट हैव वन जन्म आल्सो एटलीस्ट अन्यथा कृत विप्रनाशे सति सर्वत्र अनाश्वास प्रसंग You will have no faith at all in anything. Anything can be done, anything can happen. Shastra Anthachyankya Syat. Shastra will be anartha, useless, meaningless. Ittyatha, idam ayuktam uktam, nasabhuno bhuyo vijayate iti. Therefore, he will not be born once again if you say, it is not meaningful. Is it clear?
Swamiji, ye jo... वर्तमान जीवन में कर्म से संचित कर्म नहीं खत्म होंगे
ना ना ना
वो जन्म लेने
से संचित कर्म है दैट्स व्हाई आई टोल्ड द एग्जांपल इट इज स्टक
नो बट प्रारब्ध कर्म कैन बी अंडन थ्रू कर्म इन
दिस हां दैट्स राइट
बट इससे संचित कर्म
संचित यू कैन नॉट टच इट
तो संचित कर्म जन्म लेके ही खत्म होंगे
हां एनीथिंग जन्म लेके ही खत्म होगा I have absolute access to sanchit karma.
Vartman karma se sanchit karma ke farak nahi
padega. I wahi bol raha hu na. I can't touch it. It's something like it's fixed deposit. I can't touch it.
Yes. But the cumulative of this janma.
Yes.
Will again be added to the sanchit when I
die. Yeah. Yes. 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 If
so it will never effect will.
Yes. Yeah. If it is not used already, or if it is not cancelled by vrachita, it will go and. Stay there.
And new karma also will go.
New karma also will go. Okay?
Swami ji, aise to ye chalta hi rahega. Ye to chalta hi rahega, kabhi khatam hi nahi hoega.
Aise
hi hai. Ye
dobara janam lega, fir prarabdh ke wo hoga, uske prayaschit.
Usi ko bata raha hai shastra.
To hamara iska matlab ki hamara jo bhi agar hame dobara janam nahi lega, to fir hamare karmon pe depend karta hai.
इसलिए खत्म ही नहीं होता है खत्म होने के लिए मोक्ष शास्त्र है इसलिए है न सब भूयो विचारित है ही विल नॉट बी बॉर्न अगेन व्हेन इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड प्रॉपरली उपद्रष्टा अनंताज भर्ता भोक्ता महेश्वरा इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस देन देयर इज नथिंग हाँ इसलिए
पशु में तो कोई बुद्धि होती नहीं है कुछ कर नहीं सकता और मनुष्य में इसलिए भगवान ने
दिया इसलिए एग्जैक्ट इसलिए इतना अक्ल देने के बाद आई हैव टू यूज इट एंड पुट इट टू प्रॉपर यूज
एक स्वामी जी जब ये ज्ञान हो गया मान लीजिए किसी जन्म में तो भी संचित कर्म को खत्म करने के लिए फिर जन्म लेना ही पड़ेगा इस बार के नो एडिशन नहीं होगा
इसलिए वही प्रश्न है वही प्रश्न पूछ रहा है अभी इसको उत्तर देना है
उत्तर नहीं है क्वेश्चन
नो द आंसर इज टू बी गिवन टू दैट क्वेश्चन राइट नो सो दिस इज एन बिग एनालिसिस एनालिसिस इज फर्स्ट यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस नेमली संचिता आगामी प्रारब्ध आर थ्री आर देयर इन ईच ऑफ देम देयर इज पुण्य एंड पाप Okay. Now, what happens is, the difference between Sanchita, Agami, Prarabdha, you see. Sanchita, I have done it already. At that time, I was foolish, I did. Over which I have no control now. Okay. Now, Karishamana Karma, now. Now also it has been done. There is Punya and Papa. Maybe I will put, if I do a mistake now, Papa, I will do Prayaschitta now itself. To that extent, it may reduce also. Also in Prarabdha, I may do some prashita, something may also be get cancelled. Okay. So in Karishyamana and in Agami, in Prarabdha, I can tamper with it and do it, something, because I have connection. Okay. What is the connection? See very carefully, what is the connection? Pratyagatma is having no connection with the body or the mind. Where will all the punya and papa stock get stocked? Where? In buddhi. Is it not so?
Yes.
No, he does not have any connection with it at all. Therefore, there is neither punya and papa in pratyagatma. One who sees connection with the body and the mind, because karma is accumulated there, he feels it is mine. Because of adhyasa, he feels that this karma is mine. Therefore, he wants to do punya and he wants to get rid of papa. Or he doesn't care for it, let it be anything. I don't even believe all these things. I am angry, I will kill him. He may do that also. He can do anything. Therefore, if one gets jnana, how is he going to be get affected? Okay. Now see, start with sanchita. Karma is there. Maybe I have to get it in next birth. But now, because I have jnana, what does it mean? Because I have jnana means, I know this pratyagatman is my Brahman. I have no connection with the body or the mind or anything. I had no connection. I will have no connection. It is totally gone. Therefore, the sanchita thing cannot touch him at all.
Swamiji, buddhi phir vidya aur avidya se aati hai. Buddhi vidya aur avidya se sambandh se aati hai.
Exactly.
Aur wo uske liye shastra hai.
Ah, uske liye shastra hai. Uske liye shastra hai. So what has happened is, if he comes to know, say, pratyagatma, no connection with the mind and all, therefore, I did not have it, I am not going to have it, I don't have it now. I am an entirely different person. Then, it can't do anything, it can't touch him. Okay, therefore, sanchita karma will not touch him at all. What happens to that? Okay. See what happens to that. Mm-hmm. Now, in this Janma, everybody, Magvritti, Manavritti, Pranavritti is formed. All these vrittis are taking place only in the Sukshma Sharira. Is it not so? Sukshma Sharira is made up of Panchabhutas. Are you following? Now, because Vagvritti, Manavritti, Pranavritti are not formed at all in the case of Jnani. Following? Therefore, what happens is, when the body dies, the grass body dies, Sthula Sharira, these vrittis, they don't take place at all. It is these vrittis which simply roll like this and get me another Janma. No, vrittis are not at all formed. So what will happen? They were all in Panchabhutas. Panchabhutas disintegrate.
So, Swami,
Swamiji,
because there is no carrier for this now.
There is no carrier. There is no carrier. You understand? See, laddu is there. there is something sticking there, something to stick there, some oil, this, that, so on and so forth, everything is there. Suppose this is broken and the sticking thing is gone, the sweet is gone, the smell is gone, everything is gone. No, there is nothing like laddu. Have you understood? Therefore, this vāk vṛtti, mano vṛtti, prāna vṛtti, they don't form themselves at all. They are made up of panchabhūtas. So panchabhūtas, it will disintegrate and go into panchabhūtas.
The
sukṣma śarīra itself will not be there. Sukṣma śarīra, remember this, sukṣma śarīra has been there since infinite past. It is only sthula śarīra that is going and coming. Sukṣma śarīra will never be there afterwards. But this is coming since infinite past, it is coming.
So, mukti jo hogi, moksha hoga, wo sukṣma śarīr pe hoga.
Uske aadhar par hi hoga. Aadhar par matlab kya hai? So, this sukṣma śarīra is simply rolling. It changes the form and goes. Changes the form and goes. Now, there is nothing like it, it will disintegrate. No, when the body dies, it doesn't form at all. Therefore, it goes into panchabhutas.
It takes time?
No, where is the question there? Just as this body is burnt, it goes into panchabhutas. Okay, similarly here also, same time it is simply disintegrates.
So, jnani ka sukshma sharir form nahi hoga after
this? No. That is a big difference.
Swami ji, karma hai, ye sukshma sharir mein, it is a sort of coding mein stored hai.
Exactly.
So coding is not a stuff.
The coding is an information. Now the stuff is carrying the information. Suppose you take a CD, now I burn it. What happens to information? And there is no support for it at all. Information is not a stuff. Information, it is only a vikara, something, it's a vikara means?
Arrangement hai.
It's an arrangement.
Achha.
You have understood?
The vrittis which carry the karma and then they go. So now the vritti is not there.
Vritti is not there. No, vritti is a form. So when the stuff itself is disintegrating, where can be the form?
Swami, iska to koi cut nahi kar sakta, bilkul sahi hai. Very powerful.
Have you understood? Therefore, in the case of jnani, sanchita is simply lost.
Swami, one
question. Yes.
Swami, we have now taken this journey.
Yeah.
And we have sanchit. Where is that sanchit karam? It is
yes, it is not somewhere else, it is in this buddhi itself, sanchita is also there. This is a computer, unimaginable big computer.
So that sanchit karam, which used to take support of the
vritti,
now the
vritti
is gone,
so
it cannot do anything
for
this.
Yes. Has it become
clear? Sanjit, can we say like somebody got a property and that somebody dies and no, there is no claimer of that property, like, so the property goes back to the state. So, there is no claimer.
I will come to this point. Okay. I will come to this point. This can happen only in the case of avidyavan. Okay. Not in the case of vidyavan. Followed?
Yes.
So now, sanchita does not touch. Sanchita is simply lost. It is burnt. Okay. Now Karishyamana Karma. In Karishyamana Karma, there are two parts. Before getting jnana and after getting jnana. Okay. Now, before getting jnana, it was getting accumulated. Okay. Therefore, when Vagruti Manavruti are formed, that part simply goes also. It gets disintegrated because it doesn't come under the vritti. Is it all right? So the question remains, after he has done it, after jnana. After getting jnana, where is it? After getting jnana, punya and papa don't touch him at all. I think all of you are clearly following.
Yes.
Don't touch him at all. Because I am Pratyagatman, I am not even Pratyagatman, I am Brahman. See, we know this punya and papa are not touching even Pratyagatman. How can you trust Brahman? Huh?
When there is a karma, there is a potential energy.
Yes.
So does it mean that the karma that the jnani does, it doesn't have potential energy at all because there is, he doesn't think karma?
Yeah, it doesn't touch him.
No,
it didn't get collected at all. You see, potential was formed before getting jnana, what you say is true. After getting jnana, it is not taken into account at all. Adhyasa.
Yes.
It comes only because of adhyasa. Okay? See like this. Even more clearly. Now, doing karma, getting stored, all these things are the features of kshetra. Are you following? Now, whatever is happening, doing, accumulating, all these things, because it is in buddhi, I am buddhi, therefore it becomes mine. Okay? Now, when he has come to know that it doesn't even touch him, it doesn't even get formed. There is no kartrutva there. Have you understood? There is no kartrutva. See, kartrutva is the thing which it sticks. When kartrutva is not there, there is no sticking ability.
So, Swamiji, it means that the karma that we do with the sense that I am doing, I will do this. So, it means it creates lot of turbulence in the whole environment.
Tell it again. True.
So now when I do something, that kind of karma I am doing. So it means that is creating
a
lot of turbulence in the whole environment.
Oh, not environment here.
Outside also.
Why outside? Of course, he may create outside also some havoc. That is different. We are talking about karma accumulated in the buddhi. Okay.
So it means when we are talking of karma, the whole concept is a mental concept.
What do you mean by concept? The word concept will not enter into Vedanta.
Yes.
So it happens in the buddhi only.
Yes. So we discuss actually the physics of it. We don't talk metaphysics.
Karma happens in the buddhi.
It's taking place.
It's like that, but actually it is here.
Exactly. You are right. Because of adhyasa, it is only there. That is why I told. Somebody asked the question. upalabhate, that is, he is doing, he is enjoying, means he is seeing. It was told? Yeah. How is he enjoying? How can you say only seeing? Actually, see, enjoying is the buddhi. That is Vaishparajna. Is Pratyagatma enjoying? He is simply seeing. He is seeing even the enjoyment of Vaishparajna. Is it clear? Therefore, see, look at the power of what Shankaracharya has told. Look at the power of Shruti. Pratyagatma is already like that. You can know it. We are so unfortunate. Though we know it so clearly, we can't stay there and understand. That is the pity. There is absolutely no scope for any confusion in Vedanta. No scope at all.
Swamiji, apne Vedanta Prabodh humare ko padha de, tum ek example di thi, tree and two birds. Tree aur do pakshi.
Like that. No. That is, one pakshi is this Pratyagatma and the other pakshi is there. Okay. Actually, that pakshi and this pakshi are the same. But that is why anashna nanyo abhichakashite, without eating, it's always looking at it only. Suppose it stops eating and turns there, it becomes one. Two birds become one. Okay. So now what has happened? In this Karishyamana karma also, okay, before getting jnana, it has accumulated. But after getting jnana, it will disintegrate at the moment of death. And when he is alive, it is not recorded at all. Therefore, Karishyamana karma is also fully explained. Now come to Prarabdha.
Agami kaunse karma?
Agami is Karishyamana.
Karishyamana, Agami is...
Here in North, generally they say Karishyamana. There is no being done.
Swamiji, sab kuch Brahm hai?
Brahm nahi hai, Brahma.
Brahma hai.
Yeh sab kuch Brahma hai. Yo Brahma hai.
Brahma hai.
Huh? Okay. So, now coming to Prarabdha. Now in Prarabdha, what is happening is the following. In Prarabdha, what is Prarabdha? Before getting jnana, in the previous lives he has done, and now it is already attached to the body. This karma is already attached to this body. That is also, now it is on present deha. It is a part of present deha. Therefore, it cannot be lost. It cannot be lost because it is kshetra dharma. So, prarabdha, what? Oh, it is something like this. Now, sanchita and agami, I have fired the shot.
Bow and arrow.
Fired the shot. The arrow has gone already. After getting jnana, I don't even apply it. But the previous lives I had done it. So therefore that bana, it continues to travel as long as it has to go. Then falls down. Therefore, both prarabdha means both punya and papa that is recorded in prarabdha has to be undergone. He may enjoy also, he may suffer also. Okay. Rama Maharshi, okay, had cancer. Okay. So it is a papa phala was there. It is already attached to the body. Yes.
Sometimes people say that when a lot of people talk to Mahatmas, they help them with their that dukkha, then they undergo that dukkha, you know, they attack stuff.
I will tell you.
So what is that? Because it's a
dream, I will tell you. Oh, understand the. I suppose all of you have heard this question. See carefully. There are like that. That is all due to ajnana only. That is, suppose he says, I am doing ashirvada. I am giving this mantra. I have done this. Take this prasad. There, it could happen. But in the case of jnani, he will never do it. He simply says, karma is there, according to prarabdha, they experience, and he keeps quiet. Okay. Therefore, remember, nādatte kasyachit pāpam na caiva sukṛtam vibhuho ajñānena āvṛtam jñānam tena mukhyanti jantavah. When you are praying God, suppose I get a good phala, oh, my troubles are gone. Don't think that you have received your punya karma, all the naivedya that you have put, he has eaten and he is satisfied and so he blessed you. It is not like that. Okay. Because you have done karma, automatically that karma itself is cancelling it. He doesn't take our punya or papa. Nadatte kasich papa, nashayiv sukhrutam vibhu. Therefore, these are all the subtle things in Vedanta that you have to be very clear about. To cleanse yourself. The moment you do it, see, for instance, oh, Naivedya, I will keep it here. It's not like that. I have to think of Bhagavan and do it. So I should think that I am doing it for Bhagavan. Okay, therefore Bhagavan, my Bhagavan is linked with it. So it will handle the karma here. That is, my Bhagavan is Ishvara, one who is different from me. And Ishvara is nothing but Brahman who is in the Kshetra. Who is Ishvara? Brahman who is living in the Kshetra. Therefore, Brahman is living. He will handle it. According to the rules of the game. Because who is Ishvara? Ishvara is the one who is handling this program. Remember, whole of punya, papa, whatever it is, devatas, worms and insects, whatever it may be, a huge program.
Swami, you say the rules of the game, but kripa jo hoti hai, it is beyond the rules. Kripa jo hoti hai, jisko bolte hain, wo beyond the rules hai.
No. जो कृपा होती है मतलब ईश्वर का कृपा, ईश्वर की कृपा, ईश्वर इस उपाधि स्वपाधि का विद प्रकृति. सो व्हाट डज इट मीन? सी क्षेत्र इज देयर, ब्रह्मन इज नॉट एट ऑल कनेक्टेड, राइट? क्षेत्र इज देयर, ब्रह्मन इज कनेक्टेड, दैट इज ईश्वर.
ठीक है,
इज इट ऑल राइट? देयरफॉर बिकॉज ब्रह्मन इज देयर, ही इज हैंडलिंग द प्रोग्राम. हु? ईश्वर इज हैंडलिंग द प्रोग्राम. No, he programs, handle the program. When this karma is done, it should happen like that. When this prayachitta is done, that should get cancelled. It is only he is handling the program. I think it has done good to me. You didn't follow?
So,
Swamiji, if Devta is part of the Prakriti only.
No. See,
Devata
is the one who is possessing this energy.
But they are part of the Prakriti only then.
Power is Prakriti. One who is holding it is Ishvara, Devata.
Yes.
Okay.
Is
Brahman is Prakriti, also is Brahman itself. Here Ishvara is not Prakriti itself. Ishvara is possessing Prakriti.
Power of Prakriti. Brahma, when it is possessing the power of Prakriti, is Ishvara. And now I am asking, wo to samajh gaya. Ab Devata jo hai.
Devata is Ishvara only, like that.
They are same.
See, yeah, fractions of Ishvara are Devatas.
Fractions.
That is, Devata is associated only with this. This Devata is associated only with this. fractions of devatas are all fractions of Ishvara.
So they are part of Prakriti only then.
They have also a body and all that. You are also a part of Prakriti.
Mm-hmm.
In what sense?
Yes.
Pratyagatma is different.
Okay.
But you are associated with Prakriti. Therefore, because of association, you are part of Prakriti, we can say like that. Is it clear? Therefore, what has happened is, this both Punya and Papa will be experienced by the Jnani, whatever he has carried. There may be, he will enjoy a very comfortable life also. He may get cancer also. Okay?
That is because of prarabdha.
Prarabdha.
Swamiji, ek cheez hoti hai, wo jaisa bhi pashu ka janam
hota hai,
to ye kya manenge ki pichle janam pe kya kiya hoga jo pashu ka itna
nahi hoga. Bahut paap kiya hai.
Rakshas.
Very severe papa. That is why they take such janmas. Okay. Now, during the time of that janma, there is neither punya nor papa. There is nothing like that. Suppose a tiger kills a cow, there is no papa for the tiger. Have you understood? Now, suppose a monkey eats only mumfli, it's not get ekasi phala. Okay. Punya and Papa are connected only with Manushya. Have you understood? No? Yes?
Swamiji, when yoga says that yoga chitta vritti nirodha, but we Vedantis say that only jnana can actually remove the vritti.
Yeah.
But the Sankhya people say that even yoga process can lead up to the state where the vrittis are not formed.
No, see. When yogis say they are only having this Atman is different from the body. They are not having Brahman. They don't talk of Brahman. Therefore, there is Dvaita. Therefore, there is Kartrutva. There is Bhoktrutva. Therefore, Kartrutva, Bhoktrutva will continue. Whereas, in Shruti, his Pratyagatman is actually Brahman. Therefore, if he understands it, Kartrutva, Jnatrutva, Bhoktrutva are all lost. That is a big difference.
Can we say that in Vedanta, we get Jnana and there is no Vritti and everything is over? And in Yoga, Chitta Vritti Nirodha, we just hinder the Karma itself. And that way, slowly, it also.
Ma. Understand this, yoga is karma, is an action, is it or is it not? And there is also kartrutva. Therefore, when kartrutva and karma are also there, what sort of moksha is that?
You
are also going to sleep. That is also nirvikalpa. Therefore, that does not make much difference. You see, this is nirvikalpa samadhi, it's not going. There is nothing like going to nirvikalpa samadhi here.
Swamiji, does it push one closer to jnana than later on?
Which one?
A person who is practicing this kind of yoga.
Which one? Yoga. Oh, yoga. Ah. Hmm.
Then, does it bring one closer to this kind of work?
If he is interested. If he's into it. Oh, many times what happens is, they will do it only for the sake of Siddhis. Siddhis are also promised in the Shastra. Okay. Now, suppose he does it as Nishkam Karma. Because he also believes in Ishvara, though in a secondary way. For the yogis, Ishvara is not primary. Ishvara is secondary. Ishvara Pranidhana Dva. Okay. Therefore, if he turns to Ishvara more and more, then without caring for the Siddhis, if he goes on doing it, then just as any other good karma, it can also help.
Swamiji,
Okay? We are not condemning yoga, remember. We are only telling there is dvaita, it's not moksha. That's all. They can do it. They can do it if it is done with nishkama.
Something what I am saying is that the way we say that we should do this japa and upasana, etc. Similarly, we can, they are doing
this. See, understand this. When we are doing this, we are actually reducing kartrutva. Bhagavan, everything you are doing. Bhagavan, everything you are doing. I am nothing. There he keeps kartrutva intact. That is the big difference between yoga and this.
So Swamiji, jo punya karma hai, agar wo karta rahega, to ultimately uska matlab he will lead to matlab how only punya karma will help.
Oh, they will become devatas.
But he will not attain moksha.
No. Certainly
so how,
not.
Matlab, it will automatically not push him towards this knowledge or
interest. He, there is nothing like automatically. If he has done punya, he will enjoy actually without restriction. Okay. Therefore, it is rare among devatas who will try for jnana. It is more probable in the manush janma, not in the case of devata janma. Because everything is so comfortable, he doesn't bother. In fact, he wants to be born as devata once again.
So, dukh sabse mahatvapurna hai. Dukh sabse mahatvapurna hai. Dukh. Dukh aur takleef sabse.
Dukh, see.
Because only when you are in dukh, then you will get into interest of this karma.
That's right. Generally, that is why, no, some viveki may get, jnana there also. It depends on his samskara. Okay, something he might have done nishkam karma some time ago, so he may get this. But the probability in manush janma is more because there is constant grief like this. Huh?
Swamiji, when we are doing that process of puja and upasana, when we are doing that process, the whole thing is about surrender.
What thing
about?
Kartrutva goes only in jnana. Kartrutva is reducing in this upasana. And kartrutva is kept intact in yoga.
So in our upasana, we have to focus on the surrender.
Yeah, that's why. So it came here. Sarvatma bhava rupe anta. That is, what does it mean? It means that whatever I see is Vasudeva.
Yeah.
Whatever is happening is Vasudeva. Is it not told there? Yeah. Therefore, you are always simply telling everything is Vasudeva and I am zero. I am not a non-entity.
So Swamiji, ye jo karma, akarma aur vikarma hai, they are only bifurcation of karishma and karma.
Yes. Such things can happen. No, in the karishmana is not there. See.
No, karma, akarma aur vikarma ka jo bhed hai.
No. Karma means doing action. Akarma is not doing action.
No, but akarma is
Nishiddha karma. Nishiddha karma is that is papa. Akarma is not that.
No, Gita says three types of karma, no? Karma, akarma, vikarma.
No, I'll tell you. Vikarma is papa.
Papa.
Akarma is keeping quiet. Karma is proper karma. Okay? Like this. Actually, karma is also in general action. In that shloka, okay. So we have drifted.
Yes.
So have all the questions been answered now? Okay.
Swamiji, the karma yoga also will.
Huh?
Karma yoga will also decrease the kartrutva.
Ah. But that is why we do karma yoga. That is why I have been stressing, all of you should note, karma yoga, I am stressing. Some people have studied Vedanta superficially, where they will say, what is karma? This is more higher level. They think like that. But it's pointless. Unless one does karma yoga, it is impossible for him to keep one step forward. He has to reduce his kartrutva. That is why stick to karma yoga. Do more and more karma with dedication. That is the only way you can go ahead. Okay? Still a few more minutes? 5 minutes? Okay. See. Kshiyante chasya karmani asmin drishte barabare. What does it mean? See, from the case of jnani, kshiyante chasya karmani. Oh, tadmin drishte barabare. That is, Brahman. Brahman is para, karan rupa. Avara is kari rupa. Whether it is kari rupa or karan rupa, everything is Brahman. I go on today. When I understand that Brahman is myself, I am in kari rupa, in karan rupa, my swarupa. This is sarvat bhava. Like that. Kshiyante chasya karmani. All his karmas are lost. Okay. Brahma veda brahmaiva bhavati. Understood? He becomes Brahman. Tasya tavadeva charam. Means this. His limit is only up to the death of this body. The moment this body is lost, it is lost forever. That is the gist of that mantra. Tasya tavadeva charam. Ishikatura sarvani karmani pradhuyante. Ishikatura means you see some tall grass like things, and there it will be only bushy like this. The stick will be there. Now in this the fiber like thing will be there, you know. When it is dry and you put it in fire, it becomes bhasma in no time. Ishika is that. Ishika is this stick entire. And tula is that, the fiber like thing. Ishika tulavat sarvani kramani pradhuyante. They will be burnt. Totally burnt. Because understand this, totally burnt means what? It has completely gone. It has merged in panchabhutas.
So
it,
the burnt
ka
matlab hai
ki
destroyed totally, matlab
ye matlab hai. Totally destroyed.
Itna matlab
hai. Totally destroyed. Ityadi shrutishtebhyah uktah vidushah sarvakarma dahah. Therefore, many shrutis have told sarvakarma dahah. All things have been burnt. Yahapi uktah yathe idham samiddhagni basmasat kurte arjuna. Aisa, like this. That is, like ityadina sarvakarma bhakshya upapatteshcha. We'll stop here.
ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः।